Good morning, IIT students. Here in this video, as you know, we are working on the different operations that we can conduct on the data frame of Python Panda. Here we will discuss three different operations today. The very first operation, it is known as iteration on rows and columns. As you know, a data frame, if you see a data frame, just see, this is the example of a data frame. If you see the data frame properly, it is a combination of columns. TCS, the first column, Wipro, it is the second column, and the name of the column is TCS and Wipro. And the data frame is a combination of different rows. Here, if you can see, the index of the first row, it is QTR1, then the index QTR2, QTR3, and QTR4. These are the indexes of the rows, and here in this data frame, four rows are there. Right? Now, the very first operation and very important operation, it is known as iteration on rows and columns. So, what is there in this iteration? What is the meaning of this iteration? Right? Here, just see, if a data frame is created like this, and if you want to show the whole data frame on the monitor, for that the command is what? It is print, and just write the data frame name inside the small bracket of print. Right? When you supply this command, the whole data frame, it will be there on the monitor. Each and every columns are there, each and every rows are there as an output. Right? Now what will happen? If you want to show your data frame line by line, or if you want to show the data frame column by column, suppose the very first row, it will be there on the monitor at the first time. Then the second row element is there, then the third row, and the fourth row. Means what? Iteration means to separate or to show your data frame either row by row or column by column. The first column values are there in the first iteration. Second column values are there in the second iteration. So here, two different functions are related with this operation. ITER stands for iteration. Rows means just show the data frame row by row, each and every row, first row, then second row, then third row, then fourth row, and so on. And the second function, ITER, iteration items. Items represents columns. Right? So, by these two functions, you can divide your data frame into rows or columns. How? Now, just see the sample program here. If you want to use ITR row and ITR items function of the data frame, you just use for loop for that. Right? So, here, for row index, comma, row value in df.itemRows. Item rows means what? We are going to divide our data frame row by row. Right? Row by row means what? This is the very first row of the data frame. Quarter 1, it is the index. 24,000, it is the first column value. 48,000, it is the second column value. So, we want to see the data frame row by row. First row, then second, then third, then fourth. So, for that, we use ITR rows. Done? Now, what is there? Here, row index, it indicates quarter 1, quarter 2, quarter 3, and quarter 4. These are the row indexes. And then, row value means what? 24,000, 48,000, these two are the row values of the data frame. Right? Now, just see what is there in the for loop. Print row index is row index. Here, your data frame is separated row by row. So, very first row index, it should be there on the monitor. Then, row values are row value. When you execute this loop very first time, then what is the output? Just see the output over here. Row index is, kya likha tha? Row index means quarter 1. First row index, it is quarter 1. Then, just see, row values are here. Row values are, this is the message in the print command, and raw value, it is a function, it is an attribute related to the data frame. If you want to see values that are there in the raw, you can use raw value attribute. Right? So here, what is there? TCS 24,000, Wipro 48,000. Dekho kaise appear ho raha hai. Just see the output. quarter one, TCS, the value of TCS is 24,000, value of Wipro is 48,000. Now just see the output, raw index is quarter one and values are separated. TCS 24,000, Wipro 48,000. Right? It is the very first output if you execute the for loop at one time only. Now, what will happen? For loop, it is a repeated instruction, it is a repeated operation in our programming. Now just see, when your for loop executes at the second time, then what is the result? Raw index is quarter 2, just see, the second raw will be there, quarter 2. Raw values are TCS, Wipro, TCS 48,000, Wipro 67,000. Right? So by this, the for loop will show each and every raw of your data frame. Right? Now, if you want to see the data frame column by column, for that the command is iter, iteration items. I am telling the student, you will get 2 marks question related with these two functions, very important functions. Now here, for column name, it is an attribute of your data frame. Column name represents the name of the column. TCS will be there, Wipro will be there. Now, comma, column values, what are the column values? TCS, column values are 24,000, 48,000, 64,000 and 32,000. These four values are there in this TCS column. Right? So here, for column name, comma, column value in df.itr items. Now here, print column name is column underscore name. Here, just see the output of this particular program. This is the output of this program. Column name is TCS. Column values are, just see, column values are, this message will be there on the monitor, and then column value. Computer will show the value that is there in the TCS column with the indexes. Right? Quarter 1, 2, 3, 4, 24,000, 48,000, 64, 32. Right? These values are there only in the TCS column. Now, at the second time, when computer execute the for loop, the second column, kya aayega, what will be the output here? The output is, column name is, at the second time, column name is Wipro, right? And then, column values are, quarter 1, 48,000, quarter 2, 67,000, quarter 3, 32,000, quarter 4, 34,000, right? These values are there on the monitor as an output. Done. Now, these two functions are there with our data frame. Now we will discuss about how to delete a column, the second operation. In the previous video we discussed that operation already, but here in this video just see some advanced formats related with these, related with deletion of a column. Here in Python, in Panda, there are 3 different commands, or we can say command as well as functions, to delete a particular column. What is the meaning of deletion of column? Means if you want to delete the TCS column permanently from the data frame, then you can use these 3 different operations. DEL, it is the command of Python. POP, it is a function of Python. DROP, it is also a function of Python. If you use any Python function, you just use a small bracket with the function, and your the attributes are there inside this small bracket. So just see what is the command that we can use with this. See the very first command, DEL. If you want to delete the TCS column from this data frame, DEL, DF, bracket, and inside the square bracket, just write the column name which you want to delete completely from the data frame. Here, delete space DFTCS means what will happen now? TCS column is removed from the data frame, and now if you want to see, just use print DF. The output is quarter 1, Wipro 48,000, quarter 2, Wipro 67,000. Right? Means the TCS column is deleted from your data frame. Now, just see the second command. If you want to delete the second column by using pop function, now your command is df.pop. Pop is a function. So you should connect this function with the data frame by using dot. df.pop, a small bracket, TCS. The same thing will happen. The TCS column will be deleted from the data frame. Now just see what is there with this drop command here. The drop command gives us the facility to delete your, to delete columns of your data frame and also to delete rows from your data frame. You can use drop function for column deletion as well as row deletion also. Here, just see, df1, one new data frame is created in this line, df1 equal to df.drop, here it is the column name, TCS, and then comma, axis1, right? In your data frame, two different axes are there, the column, TCS, Wipro, these columns are there on the axis 1 position, and then this one, the indexes, these are there at the axis 0 position, right? Axis 0 means indexes, axis 1 means column. Done. So here, if you use df.drop TCS, axis 1, computer is going to remove this TCS column from the axis 1, right? Now, just use this drop command with the indexes. df.drop index equal to quarter 3, quarter 4, comma axis equal to 0. Axis equal to 0 means raw indexes. Now what will happen? Computer is going to remove these two indexes, these two rows from the data frame. Quarter 3, the whole row will be removed. Quarter 4, the complete row will be removed from the data frame. And now, the DF2, the new created data frame, contains quarter 1 and quarter 2, these two rows on them. Right? So, these are the delete operations. Now, the last one, head and tail. Head. We will discuss this head and tail operation in the data series chapter very well. Head means top 5 rows, right? If you use the command, just see, if I use the command like this one, print df.head, bracket, and then this print command, close. Dot head, if the bracket is vacant, the bracket is empty, head function bracket is empty, it means computer is going to show top 5 rows of your data frame on the monitor, right? Now, if you use any digit with this head function, such as df.head, here I am using 2, means what? Top 2 rows of the data frame will be there as an output. Top 2 row means quarter 1, quarter 2, these top rows will be there on the monitor as an output, right? If you use head 2, if you remove this 2 from the head, just see the previous command. Now, by default, computer will generate top 5 rows, computer will show top 5 rows of your data frame, right? The same thing, it is there with tail function. Tail means what? Bottom 5 rows. If you use the function tail with empty bracket, bottom 5 rows with the indexes, with the column name, these 5 rows will be there as an output, right? If you put a value with this tail, suppose I am using print, now just see my command here, print and then df.tail 2, now what will be the output? These type of questions will be there as an output generation question, one mark question will be there in this question paper. What is the result of print df.tail 2? What will be the result? What will be the output? TL2 means last 2 rows will be there. So just see, last 2 rows of the data frame, these 2 rows will be there as an output. Here, 2 rows with the column heading TCS, Wipro will be pasted over here. So TCS, Wipro, quarter 3, quarter 4, last 2 rows will be there if you use this command. Done? So these 3 functions are there covered in this video lecture. In the next video, we will discuss about advanced operations of LOC and ILOC function. Right? Thank you very much.